Welcome back, Math Grizz. Today, we will use the distributive property of multiplication. Let's take a look at this large array. We need to first take a look at our rows. Rows go across. We have three rows of cookies with 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 cookies on each row. That means that our multiplication sentence is 3 times 7. Now we will break up the array into two smaller arrays. Let's take a look at the green array. We notice that we have two rows going across with 7 cookies on each row. Now we know that 2 groups of 7 makes 14 cookies. On our blue array, we notice that we have 1 row of 7 cookies. 1 row of 7 cookies makes 7 cookies. Now we can combine 14 and 7, we can add them, and we will get 21. That means that 3 times 7 has a product of 21, because 2 times 7, which is 14, plus 1 times 7, which is 7, and we get a total of 21. Now this array has 4 rows going across with 6 muffins on each row. That means that the multiplication sentence for this array is 4 times 6. Now if we break up this array into two smaller arrays, we have a green array and a blue array. For our green array, we have 3 rows going across, so we know that's 3 times 6 muffins on each row. Now 3 rows of 6 muffins makes 18 muffins. Now our blue array, we have 1 row of 6 muffins. 1 times 6 is 6. Now we can add the product of 3 times 6, which is 18, plus 1 times 6, which is 6, and that gives us 24. So we know that 4 times 6 equals 24, because 18 plus 6 makes 24. This large array has 5 rows going across with 6 muffins on each row. We will write 5 times 6. Now we will break up this array into two smaller arrays. For our green array, we notice that we have 3 rows going across with 6 muffins on each row. 3 times 6 makes 18 muffins. Below, we have 2 rows of 6 muffins on each row. We know 2 times 6 makes 12. We can add 3 times 6, which is 18, plus 2 times 6, which is 12. 18 plus 12 makes 30. So 5 times 6 equals 30. This large array has 6 rows going across with 3 donuts on each row. Let's write 6 times 3. Now we will break up this array into two smaller arrays. Our green array has 2 rows going across with 3 donuts on each row. 2 times 3 equals 6. Now let's look at our blue array. We have 4 rows going across with 3 donuts on each row. We know that 4 times 3 makes 12. Now we can add 2 times 3, which is 6, plus 4 times 3, which is 12. 12 and 6 make 18. So 6 times 3 must equal 18. This large array has 6 rows with 6 donuts on each row. We will write 6 times 6. Let's break up the array into two smaller arrays. Our green array has 3 rows of 6 donuts, which is 18 donuts. Our blue array has 3 rows of 6 donuts, which is also 18 donuts. We can add 3 times 6 plus 3 times 6, which will give us 36. So 6 times 6 must equal 36, because 18 and 18 make 36.